Thank you. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. The corn is as high as an elephant's eye, and it looks like it's climbing clear up to the sky. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. All the cattle are standing like statues. All the cattle are standing like statues. They don't turn their heads as they see me ride by. But a little brown maverick is winking her eye. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way.
Hi, Neller.
Scare me to death. What are you doing around here?
Come a singing to you.
All the sounds of the earth are like music. All the sounds of the earth are like music. The breeze is so busy, it don't miss a tree. And an old weeping willer, she's just laughing at me. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. Oh, what a beautiful day.
If I wasn't an old woman, if you wasn't so young and smart-alecky, why, I'd marry you and get you to sit around at night and sing to me.
Well, no, you wouldn't either. Because I wouldn't marry you near none of your kinfolk if I could help it.
Oh, none of my kinfolks, huh?
And you can tell them that. All of them. Including that niece of yours, Miss Laurie Williams. Aunt Eller, if I was to ask you where Laurie was at, where'd you tell me she was at?
Well, I wouldn't tell you at all. Far as I can make out, Laurie ain't paying you no heed.
She don't take to me much, huh? I mean, where'd you get such an uppity niece out anyway that wouldn't pay no heed to me? Who's the best bronc buster in this year territory?
You, I bet.
And who's the best bulldogger in 17 counties? Me. That's who. And looky here. I'm handsome, ain't I?
Purdy as a pitcher.
And curly-headed, ain't I? And bow-legged from the saddle from God knows how long, ain't I?
Couldn't stop a pig in the road.
Then what else she want? The dang she-mew?
I don't know. But I'm sure certain it ain't you. Say, who you taking to the box social tonight?
I ain't thought much about it.
I bet you come over to ask Laurie.
What if I did?
You asked of me too? I wear my fascinator.
Yeah, you too.
Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. Oh, I thought you was somebody. I've got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way.
Is this all that's come a-calling and already 10 o'clock of a Saturday morning?
You knowed it was me for you opened the door.
No such of a thing.
You did too. You heard my voice and you knowed it was me.
I heard a voice a-talking Emily along with Aunt Eller. And I heard someone a-singing like a bullfrog in a pond.
You did too. So you sat up in there thinking up something mean to say. I'm a good mind not to ask you to the box social.
If you did ask me, I wouldn't go. Besides, how'd you take me? You ain't bought a new buggy with red wheels onto it, have you?
Well, no.
And a spanking team with the bridles all jingling?
No.
Expect me to ride on behind old Dunn, I guess. You better ask that old Cummins girl you took such a shine to over across the river.
If I was to ask you, there'd be a way to take you, Miss Laurie Smarty.
Oh, they would?
when I take you out tonight with me. Honey, is the way it's gonna be. You will sit behind a team of snow-white horses in the slickest gig you ever seen.
Lance!
Chicks and ducks and geese better scurry when I take you out in a surrey. When I take you out in a surrey with the fringe on top. Watch that fringe, see how it flutters while I drive them high-stepping strutters. Nosy pokes will peek through the shutters and their eyes will pop. The wheels are yellow, the upholstery's brown, the dashboard's genuine leather. With icing glass curtains you can roll right down in case there's a change in the weather. Two bright side lights a-winkin' and blinkin'. Ain't no finer rig I'm a-thinkin'. You can keep your rig if you're thinkin' that I'd care to swap for that shiny little surrey with the fringe on the top.
Would you say the fringe was made of silk?
Wouldn't have no other kind but silk.
Has it really got a team of snow-white horses?
One's like snow, the other's more like milk.
So you can tell them apart?
All the world will fly in a flurry when I take you out in a surrey. When I take you out in a surrey with the fringe on top. When we hit that road hell for leather, cats and dogs will dance in the heather, birds and frogs will sing all together, and the toads will hop. The wind will whistle as we rattle along, the cows will moo in the clover, the river will ripple out a whispered song, and whisper it over and over. Don't you wish it go on forever? Don't you wish it go on forever? Don't you wish it go on forever? And it never stop in that shiny little surrey with the fringe on the top.
You'd sure feel like a queen setting up in that carriage.
Only, she talked so mean to me a while back, Aunt Ellen. I'm a good mind not to take her.
Ain't said I was going.
Ain't asked you.
Where'd you get such a rig at? I bet he's went and hired a rig over Claremore, thinking I'd go with him.
That's all you know about it.
Spent all his money hiring a rig and now ain't got nobody to ride in it.
Hired it? Didn't have to. Made the whole thing up out of my head.
What, made it up?
Dashboard and all.
Get off the place, you! Ain't Eller, make him get himself out of here! Telling me lies.
Making up a few purdies ain't against no law that I know of. Besides, don't you wish they was such a rig, though? Then he could go to a play party and do a hoedown if he was mine to. Then, when you was all tired and wore out, I'd lift you up onto the surrey, and I'd hop up alongside of you, and we'd just point the horses home. I can imagine the whole thing. I can see the stars getting blurry when we ride back home in the surrey. Slowly going home in the surrey with the fringe on top. I can feel the day getting colder, feel a sleepy head on my shoulder. Nodding, drooling, close to my shoulder till it falls. Kerplop, the sun is swimming on the rim of a hill. The moon is taking a header. And just as I'm thinking all the earth is still, a lark will wake up in the meadow. Hush, you bird. My baby's a-sleeping, maybe got a dream worth a-keeping. Whoa, you team, and
just keep a creeping at a slow clip clop. Don't you hurry in the surrey with a fringe on the top.
Only you said there ain't no such rig. You made the whole thing up.
Well?
Why'd you come around here with your stories and lies? Get me worked up that away. Talking about the sun swimming on the hill and all. Like it was so. Who'd want to ride alongside of you anyway?
Why don't you just grab her and kiss her when she acts that way, Curly? She's just aching for you two, I bet.
Oh, I won't even speak to him, let alone allow him to kiss me. That bragging, bow-legged, wish he had a sweetheart bump.
She likes you quite a lot.
If she lied to me anymore, she'd sick the dogs onto me.
Well, did you get the wagon hitched up yet?
What wagon?
There's a crowd of people coming down from the Bushy Head for the box social.
Curly said maybe you'd loan us a big wagon and bring him up from the station.
Well, of course I would, if he'd asked me.
Got to talking about a lot of other things. I'll go hitch up the team now if you say it's all right.
All right.
See what we brung your Aunt Eller.
Why, Will?
Hi, Aunt Eller.
What happened up at the fair? You do any good in steer roping?
Well, I did pretty good. I won it.
Attaboy.
Always knew you would.
Ain't nobody can sling a rope like our territory boys.
Well, I can't stay but a minute, Aunt Eller. I got $50. I can get it a winning.
$50? Is that what they give you for prize money?
That's what.
Lands, if Edo any... Paul keeps his promise, he'll be dancing at your wedding.
And if he don't keep his promise, I'll take it from right under his nose. And I won't give him the presents I brung for him. Come here, fellas. Come look at the presents I got for Ada Winnie's Paul. Excuse us, Aunt Eller. You get it like this. When you get a good look, you turn at the top, and the picture changes.
Well, I'll be side-gated.
They call it the Little Wonder.
Silly goats! Give me that. The hussy! Ought to be ashamed of herself! And you too! Now how you turn things, see the other picture? Wait. I'm getting it. Oh, I'm a good mind tell Ada Annie on you.
Oh, please don't, Aunt Eller. She won't understand.
Ain't no telling what you've been up to. Bet you carried on plenty in Kansas City.
Well, I wouldn't call it carrying on, but I sure did see some things I've never seen before. I got to Kansas City on a Friday. By Saturday, I learned a thing or two. For up to then, I didn't have an idea of what the modern world was coming to. I counted 20 gas buggies going by themselves almost every time I took a walk. And then I put my ear to a bell telephone, and a strange woman started in to talk.
What next?
Yeah, what?
What next? Everything's up to date in Kansas City. They've gone about as far as they can go. They went and built a skyscraper 7 stories high, about as high as a building ought to grow. Everything's like a dream in Kansas City. It's better than a magic lantern show. You can turn the radiator on whenever you want some heat. With every kind of comfort, every house is all complete. You can walk to privies in the rain and never wet your feet. They've gone about as far as they can go.
Yes, sir! They've gone about as far as they can go.
Everything's up to date in Kansas City. They've gone about as far as they can go. They got a big theater they call a Burlicue. For 50 cents you can see a dandy show. One of the gals was fat and pink and pretty. As round above as she was round below. swear that she was padded from her shoulder to her heels. But later in the second act, when she began to feel, everything she had was absolutely real. She went about as far as she could go.
Yes, sir!
She went about as far as she could go.
What are you doing, Will?
This here's a two-step. That's all the dancing down days catch on to it. A one and a two, a one and a two. Come on, Aunt Ella.
Yeah! Yeah! Woo! Woo!
Come on, Aunt Ella!
Yeah!
Yeah! Woo!
And that's about as far as I can go.
Yes, sir! And that's about as far as she can go.
What you doing now, Will?
This here's ragtime. Send a couple silly fellas doing it.
There you go.
Yeah.
Attaboy, Will.
Woo-hoo-hoo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Woo.
Yeah.
Woo.
Yeah.
There you go. Yeah. All right, now.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Will.
There you go.
Woo.
Woo. Go on, Will.
Yeah.
Woo. Go on, Will.
Woo.
Yeah.
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 Woo.
All right.
There you
go. Let's go, boys.
There you go, boys.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Woo.
Yeah.
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 There you go.
Let's go, boys.
Yeah.
Let's go, girls. Let's go.
Woo.
Come on, girls.
Woo.
Go, girls!
Woo!
Come on, girls!
Go, girls!
Yeah.
Woo! Woo!
Let's go, girls! Come on,
now! Woo! Woo!
Come
yeah.
Up there, Will!
Go, Will!
Go, Will! Come on, Will!
Will!
There you go, Will!
Yeah!
All right, Will!
Come on, Will!
Attaboy, Will!
Good job, y'all!
Yeah!
Get it,
there you go!
Yeah!
Woo!
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 Woo! Y'all go!
Yeah!
Yeah!
All right, Will.
Woo!
Woo! Woo!
Team's all hitched.
Low Curly, can't stay to talk. I got to get over to Ada Winnie's. I got $50.
Time we got going, boys. Thanks for loaning the wagon, Aunt Eller. Come on, Curly.
I'll catch up with you. Now, Aunt Eller, who's the low, filthy sneak that Laura's got her cap set for?
You.
Never mind that. There must be a plenty of men are trying to spark her, and she surely links to one of them. Now, don't she?
Well, there is that fine farmer Jace Hutchins just this side of Lone Elm. Then that old water man up at Claremore. Max, he's a doctor, a veterinary.
That's what I thought. Hello, Judd.
Hello yourself.
And then, of course, there's someone near home that's got her on his mind most of the time, till he don't know a plow from a thrashing machine.
Him?
Yeah. Judd Fry.
The hard and growly man.
Now, don't you go and say nothing again. He's the best hired hand I ever had. Just about runs this farm by itself. Well, two women couldn't do it. You ought to know that.
I just don't see why Lori'd take up with a man like that.
I ain't said she'd tuck up with him.
But he's around here all the time, ain't he? He lives here.
Out in the smokehouse.
Changed my mind about cleaning the hen house today. Leaving it till tomorrow. Got to quit early and kind of I'm taking Lori to the party tonight.
You're driving Lori.
Ask her.
Wouldn't that just make you ball? Don't you forget, Aunt Eller. Me and you's got a date tonight. And if you make a good box lunch, maybe I'll bid for it.
How we going, Curly? In that rig you made up? I'll ride astride of them lights a-winking like lightning bugs.
There ain't no made-up rig you hear. I hired it over to Claremore's.
Land, you did?
Sure did. Purdy one, too. And don't you forget, when I come a-calling for you right after supper, don't forget that you got your booty spots fastened onto your proper so they don't fall off, you hear? It's a right smart turnout. The wheels are yellow, the upholstery's brown, the dashboard's genuine leather. With icing glass curtains, you can roll right down in case there's a change in the weather. See you before tonight, anyways. Ain't no finer rig, I'm a-thinking. You can keep your rig if you're thinking that I'd care to swap for that shiny little Surrey with the fringe on the top.
Hey, Curly, tell all the girls in Bushhead to stop by here and freshen up. It's a long way to Skidmore's. And that means we'll have a lot of company. You better pack your lunch hamper.
Hey, Neller, don't go to Skidmore's with Curly tonight. If you do, I'll have to ride with Judd all alone.
Well, that's the way you wanted it, ain't it?
No, I did it because Curly was so fresh. But I'm afraid to tell Judd I won't go, Aunt Eller. Scares me. You ever go down to that old smokehouse where he's at?
Plenty of times. Why?
You ever seen them pictures he's got tacked on the walls?
Oh, yeah, I see them, but don't you pay him no mind.
Something wrong inside me, Aunt Eller. I hook my door at night and fasten my windows again it. And the sound of feet are walking up and down out there under that tree outside my room.
Lori!
Mornings, he comes to his breakfast and he looks at me from under his eyebrows like something back in the brush somewhere. I know what I'm talking about.
You crazy youngin'. Stop acting like a chicken with its head cut off. Now, who'd you reckon that is drove up? Why, it's that old peddler. Once sold me that egg beater.
He's got 8-0 Annie with him. Will Parker's 8-0 Annie.
Oh, peddler? Thought he told me. Told me that egg beater would beat up eggs and wring out dish rags and turn the ice cream freezer and I don't know what all.
Yoo-hoo! 8-0 Annie!
Hold your horses, peddler man. I want to talk to you.
Hi, Eller.
Hi, yourself.
Hello, Lori.
Hello.
Will Parker's back from Kansas City. He's been looking for you.
Will Parker? I didn't count on him being back so soon.
I can see that. Been riding a piece?
The peddler man's going to drive me to the box social. I got a sort of a tasty lunch.
8-0 Annie, have you took up with that peddler man?
Not yet.
But you're promised to Will Parker, ain't you?
Not what you might say promise. I just told him maybe.
Well, don't you like him no more?
Course I do. They won't never be nobody like Will.
Then what about this peddler man?
They won't never be nobody like him neither.
Well, which one you like the best?
Whatever one I'm with.
You're silly.
Now, Lori, you know they didn't nobody pay me no mind up to this year. Count if I was scrawny and flat as a beanpole. Then I kind of rounded up a little, and now the boys act different to me.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Nothing wrong. I like it. I like it so much when a feller talks pretty to me. I get all shaken and horned off, don't you?
Can't think of what you're talking about.
Don't you feel kind of sorry for a feller when he looks like he wants to kiss
you? Well, you just can't go around kissing every man that asks you. Didn't anybody ever tell you that?
Yeah, they told me. It ain't so much a question of not knowing what to do. I knowed what's right and wrong since I've been 10. I heard a lot of stories and I reckon they are true about how girls are put upon by men. I know I mustn't fall into the pit, but when I'm with a feller, I forget. I'm just a girl who can't say no. I'm in a terrible fix. I always say come someone lets go. Just when I ought to say this, when a person tries to kiss a girl, I know she ought to give his face a smack. But as soon as someone kisses me, I somehow sort of want to kiss him back. I'm just a fool when lights are low. I can't be prissy and plain. I'm the type that can fade. How can I be what I ain't? I can't say no. What you gonna do when a feller gets flirty and starts to talk purdy? What you gonna do? Supposing that he says that your lips are like cherries, her roses are berries. What you gonna do? Supposing that he says that you're sweeter than cream, he's gotta have cream or die. What you gonna do when he talks that way? Spitting his eye? Girl who can't say no, can't seem to say it at all. I hate to disappoint a beau when he is paying a call. For a while I act refining cool, a sitting on a velvet piece of tea. And then I think of that old golden rule and do for him what he would do for me. I can't resist a Romeo in a sombrero and chaps. Soon as I sit on their laps, something inside of me snaps. I can't say no. Can't say no. Kissing's my favorite food. With or without the mistletoe, I'm in a holiday mood. Other girls are coy and hard to catch, but other girls ain't having any fun. Every time I lose a wrestling match, I have a funny feeling that I won. No, I can feel the undertow. I never make a complaint till it's too late for restraint. Then when I want to, I can't say no.
It's like I told you. For them.
Well, I wouldn't feel sorry for any man no matter what.
I sure feel sorry for poor Allie Hackam now. Look how Aunt Eller's cussing him out.
Allie Hackam, that's his name?
Yeah, it's Persian.
You sure for certain you love him better than you love Will?
I was sure. And now that old Will has come home, first thing you know, he'll start talking pretty to me and changing my mind back.
But Will wants to marry you.
So does Allie Hackam.
Did he ask you?
Not directly. But how I know is he said this morning he wanted for me to drive like that with him to the end of the world. Well, if we drove as only as far as Catoosie, that'd take to sundown, wouldn't it? And then we'd have to go somewheres and be all night together. And being all night means he wants a wedding, don't it?
Not to a peddler, it don't.
All right. If the egg beater don't work, I give you something just as good.
Just as good? It's got to be 1,000,000,000 times better.
My, oh my, Miss Laurie, chippity crickets are how you have grown up. Last time I come through here, you was tiny like a shrimp with freckles. Now look at you, a great big beautiful lady.
Quit biting me. You ain't had no breakfast. Go and get yourself a green apple.
Now, Aunt Eller, justly said...
I ain't your Aunt Eller. Don't you call me Aunt Eller, you little wart. I'm mad at you.
Don't you go be mad at me. Ain't I said I give you a present? Something to wear?
Foot. Got things for to wear. Wouldn't have it. What is it?
Real silk. Made in Persia.
What I want with old Persian garter?
They look awful pretty, Aunt Eller, with bows on to them and all.
I'll try them on.
Hold out your foot.
Do you have any idea I was going to let you slide that garter up my limb? Grab onto my petticoats, Laurie.
Funny woman. Would be much worse if I tried to take your garters off.
Yeah, because that'd make her stockings fall down, wouldn't it?
Now give me the other one.
Which one? Oh, you want to buy this one to match the other one.
What do you mean, do I want to buy it?
I can let you have it for 50 cents, 4 bits.
Do you want me to get that egg beater and ram it down your windpipe?
All right. Don't anybody want to buy something? What about you, Miss Laurie? Must be wanting something, a pretty young girl like you.
Me? Of course I want something. Want a buckle made out of shiny silver to fasten on my shoes. Want a dress with lace. Want perfume. Want to be pretty. Want to smell like a honeysuckle vine.
Give her a cake of soap.
Want things I've heard of and never had before. A rubber-tarred buggy. A cut glass sugar bowl. Want things I can't tell you about. Not only things to look at and hold in your hands, but things to happen to you. Things so nice if they ever did happen to you. Your heart would quit beating. You'd fall down dead.
I've got just the thing. The elixir of Egypt.
What's that?
It's a secret formula. Belonged to Pharaoh's daughter.
Smelling salts.
But a special kind of smelling salts. Read what it says on the label. Take a deep breath and you'll see everything clear. That's what Pharaoh's daughter used to do when she had a hard problem to decide. Like what prince she ought to marry, or what dress she ought to wear to a party, or whether she ought to cut off somebody's head. She'd take a whiff of this.
I'll take a bottle of that, Mr. Pedler.
Precious stuff.
How much?
2 bits.
Throwing away your money.
Helps you decide what to do.
Now, don't you want me to show you some pretty doodads? You know, with lace around the bottom.
Ooh!
Ribbons running in and out.
Ah!
Do you mean fancy drawers?
All made in Paris.
Well, I never wear that kind myself, but I sure do like to look at them.
Yeah, that's all right. If you ain't going no place.
Well, bring your trappings inside. Maybe I can find you something to eat and drink.
Well, ask him, why don't you?
Allie, Laura and me been having an argument.
About what, baby?
About what you meant about that driving me to the end of the world.
Well, I didn't mean really to the end of the world.
Then how far did you want to go?
Say, about as far as Claremore, to the hotel.
What's at the hotel?
Picture this. In front of the hotel is a veranda. Inside, a lobby, and upstairs. Upstairs might be paradise.
I thought they was just bedrooms.
For you and me, baby, paradise.
You see? I knew I was right and Lori was wrong. You do want to marry me, don't you?
Oh, Ada, Annie, what did you say?
I said you do want to marry me, don't you? What did you say?
I didn't say nothing.
Oh, Susanna. Woohoo, Ada, Annie, I'm back.
Oh, Foot, just when... Lowell, that's Will Parker. Promise me you won't fight him.
Why fight? I never saw Z man before.
Hey, Doanny, how's my honey bunch? The sweetest for 110 pounds of the sugar in this territory.
Will, this is Allie Hackham.
Hi, Hack. How are you? Don't mind the way I talk. It's all right. I'm going to marry her.
Marry her? On purpose?
Well, sure.
No such of a thing.
Oh, it's a wonderful thing to be married. I got a brother in Persia, got 6 wives.
6 wives? All at once?
Sure, that's what they do in them countries.
Not always. I got another brother in Persia, only got 1 wife. He's a bachelor.
Look, Will.
Look, Will, nothing. You know what I got for first prize at the fair? $50.
Well, that was good. $50?
Catch on. Your pa promised me if I ever was worth $50 that I could have you.
That's right, he did.
You know what I done with it? I spent it all on presents for you.
But if you spend it, you ain't got the cash.
What I got's worth more than the cash. The feller who sold me the stuff told me.
But Will, will.
Stop saying, but will. When do I get a little kiss? Oh, wait, oh, Annie. Honey, you ain't been off my mind since I left. All the times at the fairgrounds, even when I was chasing the steers, I'd rope one of the hooves, pull him up sharp, and he'd land on his little rump. And I think about you.
Don't start talking, Purdy Will.
Oh, well, I've seen a lot of beautiful gals in Kansas City. I didn't give one a look.
How could you see them if you didn't give them a look?
Well, I mean, I didn't look loving at them like a look at you.
Oh, Will, please don't look like that. I can't bear it.
I won't stop looking like this till I get a little kiss.
Oh, what's a little old kiss?
None unless it comes from you.
You do talk pretty. No, I won't.
Supposing that you say that your lips are like cherries, roses or berries, what you gonna do? Can't you feel my heart palpitating and a-bumping, a-waiting for something, something nice from you? I gotta get a kiss, and it's gotta be quick, or I'll jump in the creek and die.
What's a girl to say when you talk that way?
Beautiful feeling,
everything's going my way.
Hey, Curly. Better take the horses down the trough and get the team some water.
Can right I come? Too?
That's about all a man can handle, I reckon.
Oh, I can't believe that, Curly. Not from what I heard about you.
Well, looks like Curly's done took up with that Cummins girl. What I care about that?
Come on, boys. Better get these hampers out under the trees where it's cold.
Why should a woman who is healthy and strong love her like a baby if her man goes away? We've been Daniel well and how he's done her wrong. That's one thing you'll never hear me say. Never gonna think that the man I love that among men. I'll snap my fingers to show I don't care. I'll buy me a brand new dress to wear. I'll scrub my neck and I'll brush my hair and start all over again. Many a new face will please my eye. Many a new love will find me. Never have I once looked back to behind me. Many a new day will dawn before I do. Many a like a lad may kiss and fly, a kiss gone by is bygone. Never have I asked an August sky, where has last July gone? Never have I wandered through the rye, wondering where has some guy gone? Many a new day will dawn before I do. Many a new face will please my eye. Many a new love will find me. Never have I once looked back to sigh of the romance behind me. Many a new day will dawn before I do. Never have I chased a honeybee who carelessly cajoled me. Somebody else just as sweet as he gypped me and consoled me. Never have I wept into my tea of a deal someone told me. Many a new day will dawn, many a red sun will set, many a blue moon will shine before I do.
Thank you.
I'm sure sorry to see you so happy, because what I gotta say will make you miserable. I got to marry Will.
That is sad news for me. Well, he is a fine fellow.
Oh, Allie, don't hide your feelings. I can't stand it. I'd rather you come right out and say your heart is busted in two.
Are you positive you got to marry Will?
Sure shooting.
And there is no chance for you to change your mind?
No chance.
All right, then. My heart is busted in two.
Oh, Allie, you do make up pretty things to say.
That's you, Annie?
Hello, Paul. Well, you been shooting?
Rabbits. That true what I heard about Will Parker getting $50?
That's right, Paul. And he wants to hold you to your promise.
That's too bad. Still and all, I can't go back on my word.
See, Allie?
Now, I advised you to get that money off him before he loses it all. Put it in your stocking or inside your corset where he can't get at it. Or can he?
But, Paul, he ain't exactly kept it. He's spending all on presents.
Well, see? What did I tell you? Now we can't have you. I said it had to be $50 cash.
But, Mr. Cons, is that fair?
Who the heck are you?
This is Allie Hackham.
Well, shut your face, or I'll fill your behind so full of buckshot you'll be walking around like a duck for the rest of your life.
Allie, if I don't have to marry Will, maybe your heart don't have to be busted into like you said.
I did not say that.
Oh, yes, you did.
No, I did not.
Are you trying to make out my daughter to be a liar?
No, I'm just making it clear what a liar I am if she is telling the truth.
What else you been saying to my daughter?
Oh, an awful lot.
When?
Last night in the moonlight.
Where?
Walks out of haystack.
Listen, Mr. Cons.
I'm listening. What else you say?
He called me his Persian kitten.
Why'd you call her that?
I don't remember.
I do. He said I was like his Persian kitten, because they's the cats with the soft round tails.
Oh, that's enough. In this part of the country, that had better be a proposal of marriage.
That's what I thought.
Is that what you think?
Look, Mr. Cons.
I'm looking.
I'm no good. I'm a peddler. A peddler travels up and down and all around, and you'd hardly ever see your daughter no more.
That'd be all right. You take care of her, son. Take care of my little rosebud.
Oh, Paul, that's pretty. You sure for certain you can barely let me go, Paul?
Are you sure, Mr. Cons?
You just try and change my mind.
Oh, Allie, ain't it wonderful Paul making up his mind for us? He won't change neither. Once he give his word that you can have me, why, you got me!
I know, I got you.
Miss Allie Hackham, the peddler's bride. Wait till I tell the girls.
Trapped! Pricked! Or blinked! Ambushed!
Grim, what's on your mind? Why do you walk around and around with your hands folded behind? And your chin's gripping the ground.
20 minutes ago, I am free, like a breeze. Free like a bird in the woodland wild. Free like a gypsy, free like a child. I'm unattached. 20 minutes ago, I can do what I please. My cigar ashes on a rug. Dunk with a donut, drink from a jug. Oh, I'm a happy man. I'm minding my own business like I oughta. Ain't meaning any harm to anyone. I'm talking to a certain farmer's daughter, then I'm looking in the muzzle of a gun.
It's getting so you can't have any fun. Every daughter has a father with a gun. It's a scandal, it's an outrage. How a gal gets a husband today.
If you make fun mistake when the moon is bright, then they die you to a contract so you'll make it every night.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage. When the family surrounds you and say, you gotta take and make an honest woman out of hell.
To make you make her own, she will lie like Vel.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage. On a manhood, it's a blot. Where is a leader who will save us and be the first man to be shot?
Me?
Yes, you! It's a scandal, it's an outrage. Just a wink and a kiss and you're through.
You're a mess and in less than a year, by heck, there's a baby on your shoulder making bubbles on your neck.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage. Any farmer will tell you it's true.
A rooster in a chicken coop is better off than men. He ain't the special property of just one hen.
It's a scandal, it's an outrage. It's a problem we must solve. We gotta start a revolution.
All right, boys, revolt! packing your hamper now?
I've been busy.
You got gooseberry tarts, too. Wonder if they's as light as mine. Mine like to float away if you blew on them.
I did blow into one of mine, and it broke up into a million pieces.
Ain't she funny?
Gertie, better come on inside and cool off.
You coming inside with me, Curly?
Not just yet.
Well, don't forget when the auction starts tonight. Mine's the biggest hamper.
So that's the Cummins girl I've heard so much talk of.
You seen her before, ain't you?
Yeah, but not since she got so old. Never did see anybody get so peaked looking in such a short time.
Yeah, and she says she's only 18. I bet you she's 19.
What you got in your hamper?
It's just some old meat pies and apple jelly. Nothing like what Gertie Cummins has in her basket.
You really gonna drive to the box social with that Judd feller?
Reckon so, why?
Nothing, it's just people expect me to take you.
Then maybe it's just as well as you ain't. We don't want people talking about us now, do we?
You think people do talk about us?
Well, you know how they are. Like a swarm of mud wasps. Always gotta be buzzing about something.
What are they saying? You stuck on me?
No. Most of the talk is that you're stuck on me.
Can't imagine how these rumors start.
Me neither. Why do they think up stories that make my name with yours?
Why do the neighbors gossip all day behind their doors?
I know a way to prove what they say is quite untrue. Here is the gist of practical list of don'ts for you. Don't throw bouquets at me. Don't please my folks too much. Don't laugh at my jokes too much.
Who laughs at your jokes?
People will say we're in love. Don't sigh and gaze at me. Your songs don't feel like mine. Your eyes don't seem more like mine. People who say we're in love don't start collecting seeds. Give me my rose and my love. Sweetheart, this is magic.
Some people say that you are to blame as much as I. Why do you take the trouble to bake my favorite pie? Granted, you wish I carved our initials on that tree. Just keep a slice of all the advice you give so free. Don't praise my charm too much. Don't look so vain with me. Don't dance in the rain with me. People will say we're in love. Don't take my arm too much. Don't leave your hand in mine. Your hand is so grand in mine. People who say we're in love. Don't dance all night with me till the stars fade from above. They'll see it's all right with me. People will say we're in love. Don't you reckon you could ask that Judd fella if you'd rather go with me tonight?
Curly, I... No, I couldn't.
Oh, you couldn't. I think I'll go down to the smokehouse where Judd's at. See what's so elegant about him. Makes girls want to go to parties with him.
Curly!
What?
Nothing.
Don't sigh and gaze at me. Your sighs are so like mine. Your eyes mustn't grow like mine.
Got your hamper packed?
Oh, nearly. Yes, nearly.
Like a hanky?
What I want with that old hanky?
You got a smudge on your cheek, just under your eye.
Well, open it, can't you?
Howdy.
And what'd you want?
Nothing. Just got through with my business up at the house. Thought I'd pay you a call. Got a gun, I see.
Good. Colt 45.
What do you do with it?
Shoot things.
Oh. That there pink picture. It's a naked woman, ain't it?
Your eyes don't lie to you.
Plumb stark naked as a jaybird. Well, no, she ain't. Not quite. She's got a couple thingamabobs tied onto her.
Shucks. Ain't nothing to what I got here. Look at that top.
Well, I'll go blind. That'd give me oddies, that would.
That's a dinger, that is.
Yeah. It sure is a dinger. It's a nice looking rope you got here, Judd. Spins nice. You know that Will Parker, he sure can spin a rope. It's a strong hook you got there, Judd. You could hang yourself on that.
I could what?
Hang yourself. It'd be as easy as falling off a log. Fact is, you could fall off a log, or a chair if you'd rather. You put this around your neck and tie that good up there first, of course. Then you just fall off a log, or a chair, whichever you'd rather fall off of. Within 5 minutes or less with some good luck, you'd be dead as a doornail.
What do you mean by that?
Then people come to your funeral and sing sad songs.
Nah.
They would. You never know how many people care about you till you're dead. You'd be laid out in the parlor. You'd be all diked out in your best suit, hair combed back slick, and a high starched collar.
Would there be any flowers, you think?
Oh, sure they would. And palms, too. All around your coffin. And men stand up, and they'd bare their heads. Women sniffle softly. Some would even faint. The ones that took to you when you was alive.
What woman ever took to me?
Lots of women. Only they never come right out and tell you how they feel. I mean, less than you die first.
I guess that's so.
The singing'd sure be loud when it'd start. Like they hearts would break.
Poor Judd is dead, poor Judd Fry is dead. In his coffin now in pride. He had a heart of gold, and he wasn't very old. Oh, why did such a feller have to die? Poor Judd is dead, poor Judd Fry is dead. He's looking oh so peaceful and serene.
And serene.
He's all laid out to rest with his hands across his chest. His fingernails have never been so clean.
Then the preacher would get up and he'd say, "Folks, we are gathered here today to moan and groan over our brother Judd Fry, who hung himself up by a rope in the smokehouse." And there'd be weeping and wailing from some of those women. And he'd say, "Folks, Judd was the most misunderstood man in the territory. They used to think he was a mean, ugly feller. And they called him a dirty skunk and an ornery pig stealer. But the folks that really knowed him knowed between the two shirts that he always wore, there beat a heart as big as all outdoors.
As big as all outdoors.
Judd Fry loved his fellow man.
He loved his fellow man.
He loved the birds of the forest and the beasts of the field. He loved the mice and the vermin in the barn. And he treated the rats like equals, which was right. He loved the little children. He loved everybody and everything in the world. Only he never let on, so nobody ever noted.
Poor Judd is dead, poor Judd Fry is dead. His friends will weep and wail for miles around.
Miles around.
The daisies in the dale will give out a different smell, because poor Judd is
Oh, Judd is dead, our candle lights his head. He's laying in a coffin made of wood. And folks are feeling sad, cause they used to treat him bad. And now they know their friend has gone for good. Poor Judd is dead, our candle lights his head. He's looking oh so pretty and so nice.
He looks like he's asleep, it's a shame that he won't keep. But it's summer and we're running out of ice. Poor Judd.
Yes, sir. That's the way it'd be. Sure be an interesting funeral, though. Wouldn't like to miss it.
Wouldn't like to miss it, eh? Maybe you will. Maybe you'll go first.
Maybe. Let's see. Where'd you work at before you come here? Up by Quapaw, wasn't it?
And before that, by Tulsa. Lousy they was to me. Always acting like they was better and treating me like dirt.
What'd you do? Get even?
Now, who said anything about getting even?
No one that I recollect. Just coming to my head.
Well, if it ever came to getting even, I'd know how to do it.
That?
Nah. There's safer ways than this, if you use your head. Remember that fire up on the Barlett farm, by Sweetwater?
Sure do. About 5 years ago. It was a terrible accident. Burned up the father, the mother, and the daughter.
That weren't no accident. Feller told me the hired hand had taken up with the Barlett girl, and he found her in the loft with another feller.
And it was him that burned the place?
Took him weeks to get all the kerosene, buying it at different times. Feller told me made it I was in Missouri, but I'd known all along it was the Barlett farm. What a white liar he was.
And a kind of murderer, too, wasn't he? Get a little air in here.
You ain't told me what business you had here. Ain't got no cattle nor no cow ponies. And the oat crops done spoke for her.
You sure relieve my mind considerable.
There's only one other thing you could want here. And it better not be that.
That's just what it is.
Better not be. You stay away from her, you hear?
You know, somebody ought to tell Lori what kind of man you are. And somebody ought to tell you once about yourself.
You better get out of here, Curly.
You know, a man wouldn't feel very safe in here if he didn't know you. But I know you, Judd. There's only two things you can do in this world if you're a man. Live outdoors is one, lives the holes the other. I've sat many a night under the breast somewhere and heard a rattlesnake rattle Rattle, rattle. Someone coming too close to his hole. Somebody gonna step on him. Get his fangs ready full of poison. Curl up and wait. Long as you live in a hole, you're scared. You gotta have perfection. And you can have muscles, oh, like iron, and still be as weak as an empty bladder. I mean, unless you got something to toughen your hide with. I mean, how'd you get to be the way you are anyway? Being shut up in here, thinking the way you're thinking? Why don't you do something healthy once in a while, instead of being shut up in here, a crawling and a festering? That ought to relieve you. Sure hard on the roof, though. Let me show you something. Those knot holes over there, about as big as a dime. See it a winking? I just want to see if I can hit it. Right through the knot hole, without touching. Slick as a whistle. I knowed I could do it. You saw it too, didn't you? Somebody's coming, I expect.
Who fired off a gun? Was that you, Curly? Don't just sit there, you lummy. Answer when you spoke to.
Well, I shot once.
Well, what was you shooting at?
See those knot holes over there?
I see lots of knot holes.
Well, it was one of them.
Well, ain't you a pair of purty nothings of picking away at knot holes and scaring everybody to death? Or to give you a good Dutch rub and earn some of that craziness out of you? It's all right. Nobody hurt. Just a pair of fools swapping noises.
Mind if I visit with your gents? It's good to get away from the women for a while. Well, now that we're all alone, I got a few Bertie's private knickknacks for to show you. Especially for them men folk.
I'll see you gentlemen later. I gotta pick up a Surrey I hired for tonight.
Art postcards?
Who you think you're taking that Surrey?
Aunt Eller. And Laura, if she'd let me.
She won't.
Maybe she will.
She promised to go with me, and she better not change her mind! She better not!
Now, I want you to take a look at these, straight from Pierre.
Don't want none of them. Got any frog stickers?
You mean one of them long knives? What would you want with a singer like Zet?
I don't know. Kill a hog or a skunk, it's all the same, ain't it? I'll tell you what I'd like if you got one. Ever heard one of them things called the Little Wonder? You hold it up to your eye to see pictures, only that ain't all there is to it. Not quite. You see, there's a little jigger on the side, and you press it, and out springs a sharp blade.
On a spring, eh?
Say to a fella, look here. It's up to his eye, and you press the jigger, out comes the blade, and bang! Down you come.
Good joke to play on a friend. I don't like to handle things like that. Too dangerous. Now what I would like to show you is my new stock of postcards.
Don't want none of them.
All right, you're tired of them. So, sew yours away and buy some new ones. You get tired of a woman, what can you do? Nothing, you just get tireder and tireder.
I made up my mind.
So, you want a real woman? Do you happen to know a girl named Edo Annie?
I don't want her.
I don't want her either, but I got her.
Don't want nothing from no peddler. I want real things. What am I doing here? Like that feller said, a crawling and a festering. What am I doing in this lousy smokehouse?
The floor creaks, the door squeaks, and the field mouse a nibbling on the broom. And I sat by myself like a cobweb on a shelf by myself in a lonely room. But when there's a moon in my window and it slants down a beam across my bed, and the shadow of a tree starts a dancing on a wall, and a dream starts a dancing in my head, and all of the things that I wish for turn out like I want them to be, and I'm better than that smart aleck cowhand who thinks he's better than me. And the girl that I love and afraid of my arms and her own soft arms keep me warm, and a long wavy hair falls across my face just like the rain in a storm. The floor creaks, the door squeaks, and the mouse starts nibbling on a broom. And the sun flicks my eyes, it was all a pack of lies. I'm awake in a lonely room. I ain't gonna dream about her arms no more. I ain't gonna leave her alone. Going outside, give myself a bride. Give me a woman to call my own.
And in your future, I see a dark, handsome man.
Girls, could you go somewhere else and tell fortunes? I gotta be here by myself.
Look, she bought that old smelling salts the peddler tried to sell us.
It ain't smelling salts. It's gonna help me make up my mind for me. Look at me take a good whiff now.
That's the camphor.
Please, girls, go away.
Hey, Lori, is it true you're letting Judd take you tonight instead of Curly?
Tell you when I think everything out clear. Beginning to see things clear already.
I can tell you what you want.
Out of your dreams and into his arms you long to fly. You don't need each lips and smelling salts to tear you out. Oh, I will give
I'm
Thank you. time to get ready for the party.
Should be friends. Oh, the farmer and the cowman should be friends. One man likes to push a plow, the other likes to chase a cow, but that's no reason why they can't be friends. There's why folks should stick together, there's why folks should all be pals. Cowboys dance to the farmer's daughters, farmers dance to the ranch's cows.
There's why folks should stick together, there's why folks should all be pals. Cowboys dance to the farmer's daughters, farmers dance to the ranch's cows.
Changes. He come out west and built a lot of fences.
Built some riding walls on our own ranges.
Yeah!
Find those dirt scratchers stay in Missouri where they belong.
Gentlemen, shut up! He's a good and thrifty citizen.
He's thrifty, all right.
No matter what the cowman says or thinks, you seldom see him drinking in a bar room. But the farmer and the cowman should be friends. Oh, the farmer and the cowman should be friends. The cowman ropes a cow with ease. The farmer steals our butter and cheese, but that's no reason why they can't be friends.
Territory folks should stick together. Territory folks should all be pals. Cowboys dance to the farmer's daughters. Farmers dance to the rancher's gals.
I'd like to say a word for the cowboy.
Oh, you would.
The road he treads is too cold and stony. He rides for days on end with just a pony for a friend.
For the pony.
The farmer should be sociable with the cowboy. When he rides by and asks for food and water, don't treat him like a louse, make him welcome in your house.
But be sure that you lock up your wife and daughter.
Who owns an old farm woman anyway?
Notice he married one so you can get a square meal.
You can't go that way, right, woman?
He can talk and I won't!
Hey! Ain't nobody gonna slug out anything. This here's a party. Sing it, Andrew. Dum diddy um dum dum.
The cowman should be friends. Oh, the farmer and the cowman should be friends. One man likes to push a plow, the other likes to chase a cow, but that's the reason why they can't be friends.
And when this territory is a state and joins union just like all the others, the farmer and the cowman and the merchant should all behave themselves and act like brothers.
I'd like to teach you all a little saying and learn the words by heart the way you should. I don't say I'm no better than anybody else, but I'll be darned if I ain't just as good.
I don't say I'm no better than anybody else, but I'll be darned if I ain't just as good. Territory
folks should stick together. Territory folks should all be pals. Cowboys dance for the farmers, daughters, farmers dance
for the ranchers, cows. Woo! 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 Woo!
I'm so hungry, I could eat a gatepost.
Who's gonna be the auctioneer?
Ain't Eller.
Oh, let one of the men be the auctioneer.
Oh, come on, Ain't Eller. Ain't nobody good as you.
All right, all right. Now, you know the rules, gentlemen. You got to bid blind. You ain't supposed to know what girl goes with what hamper. Of course, if your sweetheart has told you that hers will be done in a certain kind of way with a certain color ribbon, that ain't my fault. Now, we'll auction all the hampers on the other side of the house. Work around back here. Follow me.
Kiddo!
Oh, it's you.
I was just hoping to meet up with you. It seems like you and me ought to have a little talk.
Well, we only got one thing to talk about. I heard you got yourself engaged, Tato Annie.
Well,
nothing. I don't know what to call you. You ain't pretty enough for a skunk. You ain't skinny enough for a snake. Too little to be a man. You're too big to be a mouse. I reckon you're a rat.
That's logical.
Now answer me this. Do you really love her?
Well...
Because if I didn't think you did, I'd tie you up in that bag and I'd drop you over the river. And answer me this, and this one better be yes. Do you worship the ground she walks on?
Yes, yes, yes!
The heck you do!
Yes!
You see this bag full of presents right here? It's worth $50. That's all I had in the world.
If you had that $50 cash...
I know, I'd have Ada Wayne and you'd lose her!
Yes, I'd lose her. Let's see what you got in here. I might want to buy something.
What would you want with them?
I'm a peddler, ain't I? I buy and sell. Maybe pay real money, maybe as much as, well, a lot. Say, what's a beautiful hot water bag? Looks French. Must have cost plenty. I'll give you $8 for it.
$8? That wouldn't be honest. I only paid $3.50 for it.
I said I'd pay you $8, and I will. Say, that's a cracker,
Jay. Hey, get your hands off that. This was for our wedding night.
It don't fit you so good. I'll pay you $22 for it.
But that's...
All right, then, $22.50, not a cent more.
Hey, them hose, that was for her to wear.
I didn't hardly think that was for you. Mighty dainty. I'll give you $15. Now, let's see. 8 and 22 makes 30, and 15 makes 45, and 50 cents is 45.50.
45.50, say? You want to buy some more?
Might.
Did you ever see one of these before?
What made you buy this? You got it in for somebody?
No, it's just some funny pictures.
Is that all you think it is? Well, it's more than that. It's...
Where is everybody? Where's Aunt Ella?
They just on the other side of the house, Lori.
Lori, where'd you run to?
Now, how much you give me for this thing?
I don't like to handle things like that. Too dangerous. I guess you really don't know what it is.
Sure I do. It's just a girl in pink tights.
Either of you two seen Lori...
They're just on the other side of the house. Auction's about to start.
Hey, Judd, here's one of those things you was looking for. The little one there.
How much?
$3.50.
A lot of money, but I got 90. It's worth it.
Let's see. $3.50 from him. $45.50 from you. That makes $50, don't it?
No, $1 short.
Darn it, I must have figured something wrong. How much for the rest of the stuff in this bag?
$1.
Done. That means I got $50, don't I? That means I can get Eddie Wayne back from you.
You wouldn't do a thing like that to me.
Oh, wouldn't I? And when her paw finds out who I got most of the money off of, maybe then he'll figure out who's smart and who's dumb.
Say, young fellow, you certainly bunkhoed me.
Now here's the last two hampers. Whose they are ain't got no idea.
The little one's mine, and the one next to it is Laurie's.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, that's the end of that secret. Now, what am I bid for Edo Annie's hamper?
2 bids. 4.
Who says 6? You, Slim? Ain't nobody hungry no more? What about you, peddler man? 6 bits?
Nah. 6 bits.
6 bits ain't enough for a lunch like Edo Annie can make. Let's hear $1. How about you, Mike? You won her last year.
Yeah, hey, Edo Annie, you got that same sweet potato pie like last year?
You bet.
Same old sweet potato pie, Mike. What'd you say?
I say it gave me a 3-day bellyache.
Never mind about that. Who bids $1?
Bid.
Mine's the last bid. I got it for 6 bits.
Bid $1.
90 cents.
90 cents. We're getting rich. Another desk for the schoolhouse. Do I hear more?
Do you hear $50?
Hey!
$50? Nobody ever bid $50 for a lunch. Nobody ever bid 10.
He ain't got $50.
Oh, yes, I have. And if you're Manny Honor, that means Ada Winnie belongs to me, like you said she would.
But where's your money?
It's right here in my hand.
That ain't yours. You just bid it, didn't you? Just gave it to the schoolhouse. Gotta say, peddler still gets my daughter's hand.
Hey, that ain't fair.
Going for $50. Going.
51!
You crazy!
Wait, if I don't bid my money, that means I still got it, don't I?
Sure do.
That means this is still mine.
You feeble-minded shite-poke.
Going, going, going for $51. And that means Ado Annie will get the prize, I guess.
And that means I get Ado Annie.
And what are you getting for your $51?
A 3-day bellyache.
Now here's my niece's hamper. I took a peek inside a while ago, and I must say, it looks mighty tasty. What do I hear, gents?
2 bits. 4 bits.
What'd you say, Slim? 6?
I bid $1.
More like it. Do I hear 2?
And a quarter.
$2.
$3.
And 2 bits.
$3 and 4 bits. $4.
And 2 bits.
4 and a quarter. Anybody gonna bid any more? I got a bid of 4 and a quarter from Judd Fry.
4 and a half.
4 and a half. Going for 4 and a half. Going.
475.
475. Come on, gentlemen. Schoolhouse ain't built yet. Got to get a nice chimbley.
$5.
$5. Going.
And 2 bits.
It's too rich for my blood. I'm not bidding no more.
5 and a quarter. Ain't got nearly enough yet. Not for cold duck with stuffing in that lemon meringue pie.
$6.
$6. Going.
And 2 bits.
My, you're stubborn, Judd. Mr. Carnes is a richer man than you. And I know he likes custard with raspberry syrup. Anybody gonna bid any more?
No. They all dropped out, can't you see?
You got enough, ain't Ellie? Let's get on.
Here's the money.
Hold on, you. I ain't said going, going, going yet.
Well, say it.
Going to Judd Fry for $6 and 2 bits. Going.
Who'd you say was bidding for Laurie?
Judd Fry.
And for how much?
6 and a quarter.
I don't reckon that's quite enough, do you?
It's more than you got.
You got a $35 saddle here.
Can't bid saddles. Gotta be cash.
$35 saddle must be worth something to somebody.
I'll give you 10.
Got cash?
Right in my pocket.
Waste no time. How high you going?
Higher than you, no matter what.
Hey, Neller, I'll give you this $10 Joe just gave me.
$10. Going?
And 2 bits.
Curly.
You all know my horse, Dunn. She's a kind of nice horse. Gentle and well broke.
Don't sell Dunn, Curly. It ain't worth it.
I'll give you 25 for her.
I'll sell Dunn to you. That makes a bid 35, ain't Eller?
Curly, you're crazy. But it's all for the schoolhouse, ain't it? All for educating and learning. Going for 35. Going?
Now, hold on, ain't Eller. You just bid everything in the world you had. Can't bid your clothes because they ain't worth nothing. And can't bid your gun because you need that. Yes, sir. You need that. Well, ain't Eller, I'm just as crazy as Curly McLean. Willing to bid everything I have in the world. All for Lori. Well, here it is. All I've earned 2 years working as your hired hand, $42.31.
Does anybody need a gun? Brought a light. You, Joe? Brought a brand new last Thanksgiving. It's worth a lot.
Don't sell your gun, Carly.
I'll give 18 for it.
Sold. That makes a bid 53, ain't Eller?
Gone, gone, gone. What's the matter with you folks? Ain't nobody gonna cheer or nothing?
Oh, the farmer and the cowman should be friends. Oh, the farmer and the cowman should be friends.
That's God. The cowman and the farmer should be friends.
One man likes to push a plow. The other likes to chase a cow.
Sure, I'll shake hands.
That's no reason why they can't be friends.
That's better.
I'd like to show you something. Excuse us, Lori. Ever seen one of these things before?
Just what is that?
Something special. Put your eye up to it.
Carly! Carly! What are you doing?
Doing? Nothing. Why you scream at a man like that for? Scare the lights and the liver out of him.
Well, then stop looking at those old French pictures and ask me for a dance. You brought me to the party, didn't you?
I'll dance you all over the meadow if you want me to, you crazy old woman.
Pick that banjo to pieces, Sam!
I got that $50 cash. Now you name the day.
August 15th.
Why August 15th?
That was the first day I was kissed.
Well, I don't remember that.
You wasn't there.
Now tell me and you gotta have a serious talk. Now that you got yourself engaged to me, you can't be having fun. I mean, with other fellers. You'll have to be a little more standoffish when fellers offer you a buggy ride.
Crawfish, and dig myself a hole where I can hide.
I heard how you was kicking up some capers while I was off in Kansas City, Mo.
No!
I hear some things you couldn't print in papers from fellas who've been talking like they know.
But I only did the kind of things I oughta, sorta. To you I was as faithful as can be. For me, the story's about the way
the whole thing don't sound very good to me.
Well, you see,
I'll go and sow my last wild oat. I'll cut out all shenanigans. I save my money. I don't gamble or drink in the back room down at Flanagan's. I give up lots of other things that a gentleman never mentions. But before I give up any more, I want to know your intentions. With me, it's all or nothing. Is it all or nothing with you? It can't be in between. It can't be now and then. No half and half romance will do. I'm a one-woman man, hold up tight, all complete with slippers and pipe. Treat me like I am or leave me be. If you can't give me all, give me nothing. And nothing's what you'll get from me. Nothing's what you'll get from me.
It can't be in between.
Uh-huh.
It can't be now and then.
No half and half romance will do.
Will you build me a house?
Big enough for two, but not for three.
Supposing that we should have a third one.
He better look a lot like me. He better look a lot like me.
kiss me.
Why'd we stop him? Thought you wanted to dance.
Wanted to talk to you. Who made you slap that whip onto old 80? Nearly made her run away. What was your hurry?
Afraid we'd be late for the party.
You didn't want to be with me by yourself. Not a minute more than you had to.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm with you by myself now, ain't I?
You wouldn't be if you could have got out of it. Mornings you stay in your room all the time. And nights you stay in the front room and won't get out of Aunt Ella's sight. Last time I saw you alone, it was winter. When the snow was 6 inches deep in the drifts. And when I was sick. You brought me that warm soup out to the smokehouse and me in bed. I hadn't shaved in 2 days. You brought your hand to my head, asking if I had a fever.
I remember.
Do you? Bet you don't remember as much as I do. I remember everything you ever done and every word you ever said. I can't think of nothing else. You see how it is? I ain't good enough for you, am I? I'm a hired hand. I got dirt on my hand and pig slop. Ain't fitting to touch you. Yeah, you're better. So much better, Miss Lori Williams. Well, we'll see who's better. Maybe then you wish you weren't so free with your airs. Such a fine lady.
Are you making threats to me? Are you standing there trying to tell me if I don't allow you to slobber all over me like a hog while you're going to do something about it? Well, you're nothing but a mangy dog and somebody ought to shoot you. You think so much about being a hired hand. Well, let me just tell you something that'll rest your brain, Mr. Judd. You ain't a hired hand for me no more. You can just pack up your duds and scoot. Oh, and I even got better ideas than that. You ain't to come on the place again, you hear me? I'll send your stuff any place you say, but don't you smudge step foot inside the pasture gate, or I'll stick the dogs onto you.
Said your say. Brought it on yourself. Can't help it, can't never rest. I told you how it was, and you wouldn't listen.
Who's that?
It's me, Lori. Hey, you see Aunt Winnie? She's gone again.
Will, could you do something for me? Could you go and find Curly and tell him I'm here? I want to see Curly awful bad. Got to see him.
Why don't you turn around, you crazy woman?
Curly!
Well, you found yours. Now I got to go hunt for mine.
What be ailing the Bella Claremore? By gum, if you ain't crying.
Curly, I'm afraid of my life.
Jumping toadstools.
Please don't leave me.
Great God Almighty.
Don't mind me a crying. I can't help it.
Cry your eyes out.
I don't know what to do.
Here, I'll show you. My goodness. Get away from me, you.
You don't like me, Curly?
Like you? I say plumb away from me. You stay over there, and I'll stand over here, and you tell me what you wanted with me.
Well, Judd was here. He scared me. He's crazy. I never seen nobody like him. He talked a while, and he threatened me. So I fired him. Wished I hadn't. There ain't no telling what'll do now.
You fired him? Well, then, that's all there is to it. I'll stay on the place tonight myself if you worry about that hound dog. You better quit your worrying now, or I'll spank you. While I'm thinking about it, how about you marrying me?
Gracious, what I want to marry you for?
Can't think of a reason why you wouldn't want to?
I can't think of nothing right now, hardly.
Oh, please, Lori, ma'am, please. I don't know what I'll do if you don't.
Why, Curly, I'll marry you if you want me to.
I'll be the happiest man alive as soon as we're married. And I got to learn to be a farmer, and I see that. Quit thinking about throwing a rope and learn to get my hands blistered a new way. Things is a-changing right and left. Buy mowing machines, cut down the prairies, shoe your horses, pull them plows under the side. They gonna make a state out of this territory. They gonna put it in the Union. Countries a-changing. You gotta change with it. Bring up a pair of boys, new stock, to keep up with the way things is going in this year crazy country. And now that I got you to help me, I'll mount something yet. I remember the first time I ever seen you. It was at the fair. You was riding a gray filly of blue stars, and I says to someone, who's that pretty little thing with a bang hanging down on her forehead?
I remember. You was riding Bronx that day.
Sure was.
And one of them throwed you.
They did not.
Guess you jumped off then.
Yeah, I sure jumped off. There's anybody out here in this yard that can hear me? Lori Williams is my girl.
Curly.
She done got me to ask her to marry her.
No, he all the way to Katoosie.
Let him.
Let people say we're in love. Who cares what happens now?
Just keep your head in mind. Your head feels so grand in mine.
Let people say
I'll say goodbye here, baby.
Can't you even stay to drink to Curly and Lori?
Time for the lonely gypsy to return to the open road.
Wish I was going with you. Then you wouldn't be so lonely.
Listen, there is a man I know who loves you like nothing ever loved nobody. A man I know who stick to you all your life, and that is the man for you, Will Parker.
Oh, yeah, Will. I like Will a lot.
Of course you do. And you love those beautiful blue eyes of his and the way his face wrinkles up when he smiles.
Do you love him too?
I love him because he will make my Edo Annie happy. Show you how we say goodbye in my country. Mwah, mwah, mwah.
Ah. That was goodbye.
We have an old song from where I come from. It goes, one goodbye is never enough. Oh, I'm glad you married such a fine man as Will Parker. You deserve a man like him, and you got him.
Hello, Will. Allie is saying goodbye.
Hello, Will. I think I ought to say goodbye to you, too.
Oh, no, you don't. I just saw the last one.
Oh, you two are made for each other. You, be good to him. And you, be good to her. You do not mind, I am a friend of the family now.
Did you say you was going?
Ah, yes, I must. Back to the open road, the lonely gypsy. Friend of the family? Lucky fellow. I wish it was me she was marrying instead of you.
Well, it don't make an awful lot of difference.
Well, back to the open road, the lonely gypsy.
Now tell me, you ain't got to worry about that peddler man anymore, do you?
Of course not. Never think of no unless he's with me.
Well, if that's the case, I'm going to never leave your side.
Even if you don't, even if you never go away on a trip or nothing, can't you, once in a while, give me one of them Persian goodbyes?
A Persian goodbye? You ever heard of an Oklahoma hello?
Say, Andrew, why aren't you back at the barn with the rest of us? Never seen you stay so sober at a wedding party.
I've been scared all night. Scared that Judd Fry'd come back and start for Curly.
Why, Judd Fry's been out of this territory for 3 weeks.
He's back. I seen him at Claremore's last night, drunk as a lord.
Let's have 3 cheers for the happy couple. Hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hip, hip.
Hooray!
Say, Curly, was you scared when the preacher said, do you take this here woman?
I was scared he wasn't going to say it.
I was afraid Curly back out on me.
They couldn't pick a better time to start in life.
It ain't too early and it ain't too late.
Starting as a farmer with a brand new wife.
Soon be living in a brand new state.
Brand new state, gonna treat you great.
Gonna give you barley, carrots and potatoes.
Pasture for the cattle,
spinach and tomatoes.
Flowers on the prairie where the June bugs zoom.
Plenty of air and plenty of room. Plenty of room to swing a rope.
Plenty of heart and plenty of hope.
Oklahoma, where the wind comes sweeping down the plain, and the waving wheat can sure smell sweet when the wind comes right behind the rain. Oklahoma, every night my honey lamb and I sit alone and talk and watch a hawk making lazy circles in the sky. We know we belong to the land, and the land we belong to is grand. And when we say,
yow, hi-yip-hi-yo-yay,
we're only saying, you're doing fine, Oklahoma, Oklahoma, okay.
Oh, Oklahoma, where the wind comes sweeping down the plain. Oklahoma, where the waving wheat, it sure smells sweet when the wind comes right behind the rain. Oh, Oklahoma, every night my honey lamb and I, every night we sit alone and talk and watch a hawk making lazy circles in the sky. We know we belong to the land, and the land we belong to is grand.
Better get going in and out of the dress. We gotta get going soon.
You hurry and pack your own duds. They're laying all over my room.
Will you go hitch up the team of the Surrey for me? I have it up in a jiffy.
He's going upstairs.
Yeah!
What are you going to do, Paul? Give Lori and Curly a shivery? I wish you wouldn't.
Oh, it's just a good old-fashioned custom. Ain't never hurt anybody. You women just keep out of the way. Vamoose! Quit gabbing about it. Come on, boys.
Seems like these times men ain't got no need for women.
Well, these times women ain't got no need for men.
Yeah, but who wants to be dead? Gertie!
Thought you was in Bushyhead.
Just come from there.
Too bad you missed Laurie's wedding.
Been having one of my own.
Lance, who'd marry you? Where is he?
Is that him?
That's him.
Allie Hackham.
Did you see my ring, girl?
How long you been married?
4 days. 4 days was a life like that should count like a golden wedding.
If you married her, you must have wanted to.
Oh, sure I wanted to. When I saw the moonlight reflect off of the barrel of her father's shotgun, I thought it'd be better to be alive. Now I ain't so sure.
Allie ain't gonna travel around the country no more. I decided he ought to settle down in Bushyhead and run Papa Stower.
Hey, Will, do you hear the news? Gertie married the peddler.
Mighty nice to hear that, peddler man. I think I ought to kiss the bride. Remember, friend of the family. Hey, Gertie, ever had an Oklahoma hello?
Where do you think you're going?
I'm going to stop Beta Wayne from killing your wife.
Mind your own business.
What you doing out here making all that racket, you bunch of old pig stealers?
Come on down peaceful, Laurie Sugar.
And you too, you curly-headed cowboy.
With the dimple on your chin.
Here's a baby for you, Laurie.
Here's another.
Wedding party's still going on? Glad I ain't too late. Got a present for the groom. But first, I think I ought to kiss the bride. And here's my present for you!
Judd! Curly! What?
He fell on his own knife!
Some of you,
let me look at him!
Come on. Come on, Judd.
Here, some of you carry him over to my rig. I'll drive him to Doc Tyler's.
Curly, is he?
Don't say anything.
It can't be that away.
I didn't go to.
Can't be like that to happen to us!
I got to see if there's anything I can do for him. Take care of her, Aunt Eller.
Maybe it's better for you and Curly not to go away tonight.
I don't understand why this had to happen when everything was so fine.
Don't let your mind run on it.
I can't forget it, I tell you, never will.
It's all right. It's all right, Laurie, baby. If you can't forget it, just don't try to, honey. Lots of things happen to folks. Sickness and being poor and hungry even. Being old and afeard to die. That's the way it is, cradle to grave. And you can stand it. There's one way. You got to be hearty. You can't deserve the sweet and tender in life, less than you're tough.
Wish that was the way you are.
Fiddlesticks, growing old. You couldn't hire me to be the way I am.
Well, I don't know what I'd do without you.
Sure as you're born.
They've taken Judd over to Dave Tyler's for the morning.
Is he alive?
Lori, honey, this here's Court Elam. He's a federal marshal. He reckons I should turn myself in tonight.
Tonight?
Why, your train leaves for Claremore in 20 minutes.
It's better if Curly goes of his own accord and tells the judge.
Why, you're the judge, ain't you, Andrew?
Well, yes, but...
Well, tell him now and get it over with.
Wouldn't be proper. It's got to be done in court.
Oh, fiddlesticks. Let's just do it now and say we did it in court.
That's breaking the law. Can't do that.
Well, then let's not break the law. Let's just bend it a little. Now, come on, Andrew, and start the trial. We ain't got but a few minutes.
Andrew, I got to protest.
Oh, shut your trap. We can give the boy a fair trial without locking him up on his wedding night. So, here's the long and short of it. First, I gotta ask you, what's your plea? That means, why'd you do it?
Well, he's always been pestering Lori, and I'd always said someday
I... Well, just a minute. Don't go let your tongue wobble around in your mouth like that. Listen to my question. What happened tonight that made you kill him?
Well, he come at me with a knife and...
And you had to defend yourself,
didn't you? Yes, and furthermore...
Never mind the furthermore. The plea is self-defense.
Self-defense.
Now, are there any witnesses that saw this?
I saw it. Came out with the frog sticker.
I feel funny, Andrew. I sure feel funny.
You'll feel funny when I tell your wife you're carrying off another woman.
I ain't carrying off no
one. Maybe not, but you'll sure feel funny when I tell your wife you are.
Laugh all you like, but as a federal marshal...
Oh, shut up about being federal marshal. We ain't gonna let you put this boy in jail on this wedding night. We just ain't gonna have it. So shut up.
Come on, fellas. Let's pull into the train of Curly Surrey and really beat horses.
Well, hold on a minute. I ain't told the verdict yet.
Well, it's not guilty, ain't it?
Of course, but...
Well, then say it.
Not guilty!
Court's adjourned.
Why, Aunt Annie, where on earth have you been?
Will and me had a misunderstanding, but he explained it fine.
I've got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way.
Hey there, bridegroom, you ready?
Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way.
Thank you.
down the plain, Oklahoma, where the waving wheat, it sure smells sweet when the wind comes right behind the rain. Oklahoma, every night, my honey lamb and I, every night we sit alone and talk and watch a hawk making lazy circles in the sky. We know we belong to the land, and the land we belong to is grand.
Yippee! 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 Yippee!
And when we say, "Yow! Hi-yip-i-yo-yay!" We're only saying, "Yow!"